Like, what if you said to yourself, I will never be able to sever someone's right ventricular valve and connect a P socket unit?
What the fuck are you talking about?
What is a right ventricular valve?
It's the valve. They don't really call it that. I assume it's in your heart.
Okay. So I severed a right ventricular valve. You think I'm that crazy?
Yes.
And I've kind of been justifying me talking during the guitar videos, aside from the fact that I'm lonely and I just need to talk. But the other reason is, like, I'm not at the point where I can be singing. Like, first of all, I don't know how to sing at all, and I'm sure if I tried to sing, everyone would be like, shut the fuck up. But, my point is, I don't know how to sing, but I can talk, so talking is like singing, in a way.
In a way. In a small way.
And I could transition from talking to talking in like a sing-song voice.
No.
No?
You are good, but...
I'm good, but I am not allowed to sing.
You are good, and you are allowed to sing, and I love you.
I know why the caged bird sings. Actually, I've been caged many times, and I think I've only sung in the cage, like, once or twice.
You should.
I should sing in the cage?
Yes.
I think they strap you down if you sing too much in the cage.
That's retarded.
They strap you down for everything. Do they strap people down in jail?
Probably if they're being annoying.
No, but I mean, like, I don't know what a real prison looks like. I've only seen it on TV. But theoretically, you're in, like, a locked room, and there's nothing in the room you can damage yourself or other people with. I don't know. I guess that would be a single cell, and in reality, most prisoners share cells.
I don't know.
I don't know if it's more cost effective to create a system where prisoners share space together, but it seems like a very bad idea.
I agree.
And I think the prison system probably began...
We're gonna build a prison!
That probably began as, like, no one tried to make the excuse of rehabilitation. They were just straight up like, we're punishing you.
Yeah.
And now we're, as a society, we at least say we're trying to rehabilitate.
Whether it's true or not.
Yeah. Thank you. I think I might have told you a while ago, someone said online that they were visiting one of the, I think it was like either a new prison or a reconstructed prison, and they were like, there was like a tour, and apparently most prisons regularly have tours for the public.
I've heard about that, I find that very odd.
So yeah, I was like, why would you do that? Like, I don't think I said to him this, but I was kind of suspicious, like, have you been to prison, or like, has someone in your family been to prison? But he gave a very good answer, which was, like, you know the idea of, like, civic duty.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, at the very least, the lowest level is, like, it's your civic duty to vote. You understand that concept, right?
Yes.
So, but he was saying, like, just, like, thinking civic-mindedly, for a non-prisoner, like, people in prison are undeniably the most, like, marginalized and oppressed people.
Not that they don't deserve to be, generally.
Well, I'm just saying, like, there's good reason for people who, whether or not anyone deserves to be in prison, people who aren't told, you know, people who, to use that terminology, people who don't deserve to be in prison, to visit the prison, so, like, periodically, if no good people ever visited prison, it would be up to, like, you know, just to stop abuse, to, like, say, like...
Okay, yeah, it's, I guess, sort of the similar reason to why I always look at,
those sites.
No, why I always keep an eye on the people, if people have to get strapped down when I'm in an emergency.
Okay, yeah. If as a society, we said there are good people and there are bad people, the bad people go to prison, and not one good person ever goes to look at the bad people, and the prison is like, they could, if it was so, basically, the less monitored the prison is by good people, the more the prison can get away with, like, just hideous treatment of prisoners.
Yeah, that's true.
Thank you. Before I started playing guitar, I watched the video, you know, Ween?
Mm-hmm.
One of the Ween guys was like, the video was basically just them playing guitar, but it was like supposed to be about advice how to play guitar.
Mm-hmm.
And they showed like, I guess, some advanced like things, and, but the Ween guy said like, his number one piece of advice for guitarists was to never let the guitar cover your crotch.
I think you've told me about this before.
Yeah, I just think it's so funny, and I want to follow his advice. Well, first of all, I love weed, but like,
yeah.
But also, I don't know. It's a joke, but like, I think it might actually be real advice.
I can do that.
Advice like every single video I make. Hey everybody,
be don't aware let your guitar cover your crotch.
Mm-hmm. See, when it makes noises like that, I think there's some Satan in it.
No.
No Satan?
No Satan.
But you heard that noise, right?
No Satan.
I'm not saying it's Satan, I'm just saying, did you hear the noise?
No, I don't really know what you mean, actually.
Okay.
Sorry.
I spent so little time on that. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.